Welcome to Shurley English and the 2-Minute Tip of the Day. Today's topic is the Oxford comma. The Oxford comma, also known as the serial comma, is the comma used in a sentence before the coordinating conjunction at the end of a list of three or more items. It's called the Oxford comma because it's the house style used by the editors and printers of the Oxford University Press. Most American English style guides recommend using the Oxford comma, and so does Shurley English. In order to clarify information, the rule says to put a comma between words in a series. For example, I like apples, comma, bananas, comma, and oranges. The second comma illustrates the Oxford comma. The controversy began when the Associated Press and Journalistic Style Guidelines advised against using the serial comma in an effort to save space and pack in more news per square inch. Now, the tiny omission of the Oxford comma to save space has left a huge number of people confused about its use and purpose. The debate about the Oxford comma is a crucial conversation to me, so allow me to use contrasting. Contrasting is a technique used to clear up misunderstandings by using don't do statements. As you read these don't do examples, notice how the Oxford comma clarifies meaning and keeps any type of misunderstanding from happening. Take a look at my first don't do that example to see how the mistake can make the meaning of a sentence unclear. Then I will contrast it with the same sentence using the Oxford comma correctly. The sentence says, "My heroes are my parents, Major Man and Wonder Lady." The missing Oxford comma makes it appear that my parents' names are Major Man and Wonder Lady. To write this sentence correctly, use the do this example. My heroes are my parents, Major Man and Wonder Lady. Here's another don't do that example. I love cooking, my family and my pets. When you leave out the Oxford comma, it can become very confusing for the reader. You don't really mean you love cooking your family and your pets. You do want to write the sentence this way to show that you love three things. I love cooking, my family, and my pets. Correct punctuation matters, so follow the rules and use the Oxford comma. Thanks for tuning in to my 2-Minute Tip of the Day. Be sure to check out our website. See you next time.